Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. On the agenda tonight, we're going back to 1971. We're going to be taking a look at Yes, and they're going to be playing through Yours is No Disgrace. So let's get the guys up on screen and see how they get on. Jump in here because we've gone through so much already and there are so many elements in this track that you can focus on. The first thing that I'm getting drawn towards, of course, is the guitar and Steve Howe and the way that he's absolutely nailing all of these notes with his alternate picking within the mix. You might let it fly under the radar because of everything else going on, but Steve's playing is absolutely precise here, and every single note is emphasized exactly the way it should be. Another thing to mention is the overall sound that they're making in terms of the tightness and the maturity of the sound, given that these guys at this point are only in their early 20s, early to mid-20s here throughout the whole band. So they've got such an experienced sound that they're making in this live setup, and you can tell there is so much rehearsal that would have been required in order to get to this stage. And when I mentioned about these guys in rehearsal time, they made a conscious effort to get into the rehearsal studio and work at their tightness, but also their technical ability, because they saw a band called King Crimson in the late 60s, 1969, and they realized that their tightness, their technical ability wasn't at the level that it needed to be, because there was so much competition around at the time. And having witnessed that gig, they then started to book in regular rehearsals to get themselves to the level they thought they needed to be. And the other thing to mention are the vocals and the harmony vocals, because we've got top musicians here on their instruments, independently great players, but also they've got that ability to add a voice into the mix as well and harmonize with each other. And that leaves them so many melodic options in terms of where they can take a particular track in the studio and then reproduce it as it is on the record, but live. And just another thing about Steve's playing, the fact that we've got that really clean tone, so he's got nowhere to hide. There is a touch of delay on the sound as well, just to sit it in the mix, and the guitar that he's playing, the Gibson ES-175D, which is a big guitar to get control of, to maneuver, so it is awkward in that respect as well, but he's all over it throughout this whole performance. And when I'm talking about technical ability, that goes for every instrument in this performance. We've got Bill Bruford on drums and also Chris Squire on bass, and have a listen out to some of these bass lines that are going on throughout the performance. It's one of those that you can focus in on the different instruments and you'll always hear something interesting going on. Let's get back into the performance.
Caesar's Palace, morning glory, silly human race. On a sailing ship to nowhere, leaving any place. If the summer changed to winter, yours is no disgrace. Yours is no disgrace.
I'm just going to jump in here. Everybody is on the same page here, so tight throughout the whole band. And Steve's guitar solo there, the reason that he has to be so technically great at playing is because of that tone. But the amount of technical ability that is involved in what Steve's doing there is so impressive, to be so clear and clean with all of these runs, and also putting in a little bit of that side-to-side vibrato as well when he does linger on a note, just to get a little bit more expression. And sometimes when you are watching a video like this and we're just focused on one performer, you tend to only hear what that person is playing, whereas sometimes it's good to look away and appreciate that whole performance, listen in to those different instruments. For example, we've got Tony Kay here on the Hammond organ playing some great stuff, and the bass that Chris Squire's laying down as well. He doesn't get a lot of camera time during this video, but it's great to hear the lines that he's throwing together as well. And yes, being a progressive rock band, it means that they're going to take you on a journey, and we've got so many different elements here. Certainly the thing that stands out are the tempo changes, the way that we go from up tempo to then a really slow tempo. It's going to be like turning a corner on this musical journey, and along this journey we see so many sights. Just taking Steve's guitar as an example, in the intro, beginning of the track, we have those arpeggiated lead runs, and then as we get through the track, we're now into a standalone lead sound, but then we also have riff work that is combined with that wah-wah pedal. It's going to make it more interesting by applying that wah-wah effect, but also just the different style of playing that obviously Steve can give you throughout one performance. He can take that lead playing into so many different directions, and that'll be the case for every single player here. If they want to, they can just tweak their playing to give you a slightly different feel and to give you something different to see on that journey. And I know that in 1983, when they reformed with that new lineup, the sound changed to a more commercial sound, maybe a more pop-influenced sound, but that gave them the album 90125, which is their biggest selling album, and also spawned the single Owner of a Lonely Heart, which got to number one in the USA. So just changing that sound to a more pop-based sound might have opened them up to a totally new demographic, and they've sold over 13.5 million albums just in the USA alone. They've been nominated for 5 Grammy Awards, and they won a Grammy Award for Best Rock Instrumental Performance, and they were also inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 2017. And I know that this video that we're looking at is quite early on, considering that the band was only formed 3 years before, but even from those 3 years, the original lineup has now changed to the video that we're looking at. So the personnel changes were quite frequent, but the most important thing is having top musicians and making a great sound on the record, but also live. And once you have got those top musicians, they set the bar for the sound and the sound of the band. So it means that any performers coming in have to hit that same level, and they do. Even when the change happened to the sound in 1983 and was a little bit more mainstream, the progressive elements were still in there, but you still got a quality sound. And I'm not going to have time to look at this whole video, but the link's going to be in the description below, as always, so you guys can check out the whole performance if you want to. But thank you so much for suggesting this video for me to take a look at, and keep those suggestions coming in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you guys at the next one. Rock!